We had this library at the school, which is, I visit there from time to time. The library is still excellent, and it's in an old building with the right kind of musty smell of old books. And there was there a great treasure house of books, which, as far as we knew, nobody was aware of except us. I mean, just the four boys. Lighthill actually discovered this Cours d'analyse, which is a classic textbook of analysis written by a French mathematician, Jordan, about 1900, I suppose, and three volumes. And they are still there in the school library. I verified that recently. And nobody knows how they got there. It seemed very strange for anybody to put such a heavy textbook and all written in French for English schoolboys. But anyway, it was there, and Lighthill discovered it. And so we worked our way through the three volumes, one after the other. And that was opening the gates of mathematics in a way that very few people had, had that chance. And only many, many years later, we found out that Hardy, the great mathematician, whom we afterwards got to know in Cambridge, had also read Jordan's Cours d'analyse as a young man and been inspired by it. And it also happened that he was a boy in the same school. So almost certainly it was he who put the books there. Because typical of Hardy, he did that anonymously. There was no record in the library that he had given it. There was also the Principia Mathematica of Whitehead and Russell, which was not so illuminating, but also great fun to go through.
You actually went through it. And
oh, yes, and that's also three fat volumes, and it's trying to reduce the whole of mathematics to logic. It's extremely pedantic, just full of just enormously complicated constructions to reduce complicated things to simplest components. And it was a monumental failure. It was demolished in the end, of course, by Gödel's theorem. The idea was that one could make construct a consistency proof for mathematics by reducing it to logic, and Gödel proved that that is impossible. So the whole thing was based on an illusion, but nevertheless, it was fun to go through it. So it gave us a feeling for what the foundations of mathematics were all about.
And with an inkling that this is probably not the way to do it?
Yes. Mm-hmm. We certainly understood that, I think, after going through the three volumes. There was clearly a difference between Whitehead and Russell on the one hand and Jordan on the other. Jordan was
concrete,
really doing real mathematics, and Whitehead and Russell were not. And